Dark clouds have gathered in the sky, the wind has picked up its pace, and it feels a little cooler. Looks like a thunderstorm is on its way. For the most part, thunderstorms occur during the warmer seasons. We may have felt certain excitement or even uneasiness over this news. Still, at the same time, we are fascinated by this natural phenomenon. What causes thunderstorm and what exactly causes the event of thunder and lightning? We will get to know all in this video. Lightning. One of the most incredible natural phenomena. Lightning is an electrical discharge generated by imbalances between the storm clouds and the ground or within the clouds themselves. During a thunderstorm, as warm air rises, it cools, forming tiny water droplets. Now suppose there is enough instability in the air, in that case the updraft of warm air and water vapor will quickly develop a cumulonimbus cloud, the type of cloud needed to produce thunder and lightning. As a result of the circulating air in the clouds, water freezes on droplets or crystal surface. With time, the droplets become too heavy to be supported by the updraft of air and they fall as hail. And as they fall, the hail then picks up negative charge by rubbing against tiny positively charged ice crystals. A negative charge forms at the base of the cloud where the hail collects itself, while the lighter ice crystals remain near the top of the cloud and create a positive charge. Now, objects on the ground, like steeples, trees, and our planet itself, becomes positively charged. When the attraction becomes too strong, nature seeks to remedy it by passing a current between the two opposite charges. We call this lightning. The rapid expansion and heating of air caused by lightning also produces a loud clap of thunder. We will talk about thunder later in this video. Meanwhile, lightning can occur between opposite charges within the storm cloud, or between opposite charges in the cloud, or between opposite charges in the cloud and on the ground. Cloud-to-ground lightning flashes account for only 25% of total lightning flashes worldwide. Most of lightning occurs within the clouds. On Earth, the lightning frequency is approximately 45 times per second, or nearly 1.4 billion flashes per year. The place on Earth where lightning occurs most often is near the small village of Kifuka in the mountains of Eastern Democratic Republic of Congo. Also, the famous saying, "Lightning never strikes twice in the same place," is a myth, as the Empire State Building is struck on average 100 times a year. Lightning is extremely hot. A flash can heat the air around it to temperatures 5 times hotter than the sun. Because of this, lightning has some devastating effects. Objects struck by lightning also experience heat and magnetic force of significant magnitudes. Lightning currents hitting a tree may vaporize its sap. Tall structures or buildings hit by lightning may be damaged as lightning seeks unrestricted paths to the ground. Although 90% of the people struck by lightning survive, animals, including humans, may be killed or suffer severe injuries because of it. And here is an interesting story of an American man named Roy Sullivan, who holds the record for the person struck by lightning most times. During his life, he claims to have survived 7 lightning strikes, although he did suffer various injuries. Thunder. Thunder is created when lightning passes through the atmospheric air. The lightning discharge heats the air around it rapidly and causes it to expand. The temperature of the air in the lightning may reach as high as 50,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Immediately after the flash, the air contracts quickly. This rapid expansion and contraction is what creates the sound wave that we call thunder. Now, just as lightning can be dangerous, A powerful shockwave is sufficient enough to cause property damage. It can also rupture eardrums of people nearby, leading to temporary deafness, if not impaired hearing. The most noticeable aspect of lightning and thunder is that lightning is seen before the thunder is heard. This is because the speed of light is much faster than the speed of sound. Light travels at about 300 million meters per second, and sound travels through the air at about 343 meters per second. You can calculate roughly the distance between yourself and the lightning by timing the interval between the visible light and the thunder it generates. Usually, a lightning flash preceding its thunder by 1 second would be approximately 343 meters away. The higher the second count, the further away you are from the lightning. Dogs can hear at much greater distances than humans. They may react after hearing far away audio of thunder, basically warning of an approaching storm. Interestingly, thunderstorms evidenced because of flashes of lightning have been observed on extraterrestrial planets such as Jupiter and Saturn. Lightning there can be 1,000 times more powerful than lightning here on Earth. Lightning bolts come in many different colors. It might be blue, red, or yellow depending on the circumstances. Lightning bolts don't just heat the air around it to extreme temperatures, they also transport massive amount of energy. They carry energy measuring several hundred billion volts, and this is what makes lightning strikes so dangerous. This was the science behind thunder and lightning. Scientists are continuing to make further observation and development. Currently, we cannot harness and store the energy contained even within a single lightning bolt. Until then, just sit back and enjoy your cup of coffee or tea on a rainy day or whatever you prefer. If you would like to see more of this, be sure to check out my previous videos and don't forget to subscribe. If you have some future video suggestions, comment down below.